我刚刚开始吃素的时候，很多人问我说你发生什么事，好像要发生事才可以吃素嘛？发生什么事？我说没事啊。那你健康是怎么样？没有啊。那你会是信了什么教？我说不是，我那时候有九条小狗，我每一天早上要开两个罐头，一个鸡肉罐头，一个牛肉罐头，喂它们。所以我开罐头那时候我都可以单手这样开，开好快好快，每天都在开，所以我很容易开。开了以后就把罐头掀开，然后就开始发发发发，发到九个碗里面。那小狗都在下面，就坐在那边乖乖的等。那眼睛一定永远盯着食物。各位有养过狗的人，大概都知道。有一天很特别，就是我拿着罐头，看到我前面的那个小狗这样，舌头还伸出来这样等。那我想看到它。不知道为什么，我刚好看到罐头上面他画了一头小牛，那个小牛也是这样，我就突然脑袋里面跑出一个问题，说：哎，我用牛肉喂小狗，如果今天有人告诉我说：哎，这只牛我养的，你把你的狗杀一杀给我的牛吃，我肯不肯？我就说我一定不肯啊。那我说那不肯，那我为什么做反过来这个动作？糟糕了，就这个问题我就想不通嘛。那想不通，我想了一年还是没想通嘛，所以我就吃素了。因为多数的人吃素是因为宗教的关系，或者是健康的关系，或是奇奇怪怪的关系。那但是现在我们大家已经知道，为了要肉食，所以我们的整个畜牧产业对地球的 CO2 的 emission 是影响很大的。你看澳洲是很大很大的影响。当然你要叫很多人说把脑袋这样转是不可能，所以你要做设计要怎么做。那天我在 TED 大家应该知道啊，我在 TED 一个演讲上面看到一个很年轻的科学家，他在做一件事情，我简直佩服得不得了。
What could the future of animal products look likeIt need not look like this, which is actually the state of the art today. Rather, it could be much more like this. Already we have been manufacturing with cell cultures for thousands of years, beginning with products like wine, beer, and yogurt. And speaking of food, our cultured food has evolved, and today we prepare cultured food in beautiful sterile facilities like this. A brewery is essentially a bioreactor. It is where cell culture takes place.Imagine that in this facility, instead of brewing beer, we were brewing leather or meat. Imagine touring this facility, learning about how the leather or meat is cultured, seeing the process from beginning to end, and even trying some. It's clean, open, and educational. And this is in contrast to the hidden, guarded, and remote factories where leather and meat is produced today.Perhaps biofabrication is a natural evolution of manufacturing for mankind. It's environmentally responsible, efficient, and humane. It allows us to be creative. We can design new materials, new products, and new facilities. We need to move past just killing animals as a resource to something more civilized.And evolved.
他说：“想吃肉，为什么一定要去杀一头牛，还要养一头牛，然后还要搞半天？你为了一磅的牛肉，要用多少的水，跟多少的草，跟什么的资源，一大堆，你才生产那么一点点的肉？所以他说，他很简单。他说，既然大家都会做啤酒，那他就用同样的方式。”他就开一个类似像啤酒厂那样的地方，拿牛肉的细胞，他就开始培养各种的肉。那好好的，那你还是照样可以吃啊，可是你就不必搞那一套了，那不是也是一种 design 吗？